Hi and welcome to video 4 of the Gatsby JS series. In this video we're going to build out our pages and do some prep work ready for our header and footer components. We'll also do some refactoring using the Gatsby browser APIs. So let's jump straight in and start building our pages. As you can see here on the design we have four top level pages: home, blog, about and contact. So let's go and create these pages in VS Code. So if I just switch over to my code editor, first of all let's get that project running with npm start. If you don't remember me saying earlier, every component we create inside the pages directory is picked up by Gatsby and made into a page. It's a convention in Gatsby, the index.js is always the home page and will be on the /root of our application. So if we open that index file now, this is our home page. If we go to Chrome, we should see that our homepage has the content hello world. If I create a new file and name it blog.js, Gatsby will pick this page up and create us another root. This page will have the root /blog on our website. Gatsby uses the file name to create the routing. So let's create a component inside here. First of all, we're going to import React from React. And then we're going to import our layout from, whereabouts are we? It's back a directory into components and layout. Then we need to create our export default function. And we can name this anything we want. For searchability, I'm going to call it blog page. Then we're going to return the layout, wrapping our h1, and in that h1 we'll just write blog page for now. Oh, and we need to return all of this. If we now go to Chrome, just refresh that, and if we navigate /blog, we should see we now have our blog page. This is one of the benefits of Gatsby JS. It handles the routing so we don't have to do a complex setup. Now we know how to make new pages, we can create the about and contact page. To do that, we're going to create an about.js and we'll create a contact.js. I'm going to copy the contents of the blog page and then I'll reuse this for the about page. So I'll just change the naming and change the h1 to be about, and then the same for the contact. So I'll copy that, change that to contact page, change the h1 to contact page, and just save both of them files. So now if you look at our pages, it reflects how our routing is set up. We have /home, which is our index, sorry, not /home, just /, which represents our home page in index, /contact, which shows this component, /blog, and /about. So now we have all these in here, let's test them all out. So first we've got our home page, then we have a blog page, which we know already works, then we have our contact, and then we have our about. Perfect. There's one slight problem with this approach. Well, it's not really a problem, but it could be better. If we look at all of our page files, we are repeating the layout section. So we're importing layout and returning the layout every single time. And this doesn't change it at all. With this in mind, Gatsby exposes some APIs we can use to combat this. Inside the Gatsby browser.js, we can respond to actions within the browser and wrap our site with additional components. We're going to use two APIs provided by Gatsby, the wrap page element API and the wrap root element. So I'll write this out and then explain what it is doing. So here we can write export function wrap page element, and that gets passed elements and props. And then inside there, we want to return our layout component. And that's just automatically imported at the top for me. Then we'll just spread our props onto that. And then we want to return elements inside of that. Just give that a save. And it's failed to rebuild. Oh, because I've named that prop, not props. Just give that a save. There's still something wrong. Oh, it's a triple dot. There we have it. Hopefully that red squiggly fades away in a second. Oh, prop spreading is forbidden. So that's an ESLint rule coming in. But we do want to spread here. So I'm just going to disable this for the line. Lovely. Then we're going to write one more exported function. And we're going to call that one wrap root element. This one only returns the element. It doesn't return the props. And inside this one, we'll just return a fragment with our element for now. So we can remove that props not spreading line. But what do these functions do? So wrap page element is used to wrap every single page with another component. In our case, the layout, which puts it inside the main tags. So if we look inside our layout, the layout's responsibility is to implement theme provider, global styles and normalize, and wrap it inside our main tags. So now, the Gatsby browser.js is handling that for us and wrapping every single one of our pages with that component. So we can go into each of these pages and now remove that layout, which just tidies up these pages to where we have a single responsibility. And that single responsibility is showing the content of the page. It shouldn't have to care about the layout. Save that one and the contact one. This is a bit tedious and I wanted to show you the other way of doing it, and that's why I've made you write all this out to then strip it all away. I'm going to remove that div while we're at it. We don't need that. Perfect. So now we have a really minimal application. Now, if we go back to our Gatsby browser.js, we can talk about the wrap root element component. So the wrap root element we have created is where we want to implement any sort of providers for our application. We only have one provider at the moment, the theme provider, but currently it's coupled to our layout. So let's split that up. I'm just going to close all these other files for now. If we go to our components directory and create a theme.js file, we can get the contents of our layout.js. And for now, we're going to copy all of that and bring it into our theme. Now we have our theme.js mirroring our layout.js. Let's go back to the layout and we'll remove all the styled component stuff. So we'll remove theme provider, create global styles and normalize. We'll remove the main theme declaration. We'll remove the global styles. And then last but not least, we'll remove all of the tags related to style components. Just give that a save. With that complete, that leaves this file in a much better place. Now the layout.js file is only responsible for rendering our actual layout, which at the moment is just wrapping it within a main tag, but later on we'll add that to implement the header and footer for us on each page. Now that's saved, let's go back to our theme.js file. And with this, we need to do the opposite. So inside here, we can rename the layout to theme. And instead of returning main, as that is handled by the layout, we can just return the children. And now this component is responsible for rendering all the context and the initial setup of the styled components. Before we test this out, the Gatsby documentation recommends you copy the exact contents of the Gatsby browser.js file and copy it over to the Gatsby SSR.js file. But before we do that, we just need to implement the theme component we have just made on the wrap root element. So if I first import theme from source components theme, I can then wrap our root element with that theme. And we're just getting an error here for the props no spreading rule that hasn't been found. So just for the sake of this video, I'm going to delete that rule and just disable ESLint for the next line entirely. Perfect, so we've got success outputs there. The reason we don't want to wrap the theme and the context of the theme around the wrap page element is because that re-renders every single time we go to a new page. So if we switch between about, blog and contact, this will re-render. And we don't want our entire context and state to also re-render throughout the application. So now we have that in, let's copy that over to the Gatsby SSR file, save it there, and switch back to our Chrome window. Oh, looks like we're getting an error. So React is not defined. We've forgotten to import React in the Gatsby browser and Gatsby SSR. So if I import React from React and also add that to the Gatsby SSR file, I'm just going to kill this terminal and restart it whilst we're here, just in case, because this is around the Gatsby config files. And now that's pretty much set up. If we switch back to our browser, we should be able to refresh, see the about page. Perfect, we're no longer getting any of the errors about React components. So if we go to the about page, the home page, contact page, these all look correct now, because if you remember, styled normalize removed the margin to the left of the header tags. So if that margin is not there, that must mean that our application is being correctly wrapped by this layout. Now whenever we add new pages, we don't need to add our layouts and theme providers to them. It will automatically be added by these Gatsby browser APIs. Now we are leveraging the Gatsby APIs to supply all of our application with our theme provider and layout. We are ready to move on to the next video, where we're going to start implementing the header and footer of our application. Thanks.